Hey, Juicers. So, how and why exactly did the faces of four of our most famous presidents end up carved into the side of a mountain in Black Hills, South Dakota? Well, it all started in 1923 when this guy, Doan Robinson, a historian in South Dakota, had a cool idea. Robinson wanted to sculpt faces of some of America's most famous heroes into a mountainside. So, he asked this guy, a famous sculptor named Gutzon Borglum, to help make his dream come true. It was Borglum who decided on presidents and which ones, and after an okay from President Coolidge and some money from the U.S. government, carving of Mount Rushmore began in 1927. First came George Washington, who was chosen because he was, well, the first president. Second came Thomas Jefferson because he wrote the Declaration of Independence and basically doubled the size of America during his time with the Louisiana Purchase. Next came Abraham Lincoln, who represents unity and the preservation of the United States. And last but not least came Theodore Roosevelt, who was chosen because of his conservation efforts and development of national parks. Over 400 workers helped sculpt the faces and had to climb 506 steps every day to do it. The entire project cost exactly $989,992.32, and wasn't completed until 1941, 14 years after it started. Attracting over 2 million visitors every year, the Mount Rushmore National Memorial, also known as the Shrine of Democracy, still stands strong today. And that's the juice.